Good evening, San Diego Civic Dance Arts families. Thank you for joining us tonight. I know you're not here to hear me speak. You're here to see your dancers dance.
Oh,
we have a short program before the dancers come out. I'm proud to welcome Tom Hickey and Stacy Jansen to the stage. They will be paying a little bit of tribute to some of our wonderful dancers that you all know so well. Take it away, Tom, our vice president.
Good evening, everybody. We like to start tonight off by honoring one of our seniors. So if we could have Destiny please come to the stage. We wanted to thank you for your years with SCCDA, for being part of our program, and we look forward to seeing great, wonderful things from you in the future. Thank you, Destiny. It is my pleasure, again this year, to be the MC for our Scholarship Program Awards. This year, we are only honoring our Bonnie Ward applicants. So the Bonnie Ward Scholarship is for our graduate and seniors. It provides them with a scholarship for their first year of college. These girls were selected because they showed the values and characteristics that SCCDA honors and appreciates. They are outgoing, enthusiastic, they give back to the program and to the community. So with no further ado, we'll start with our first dancer. So I got Dalen, come to the stage. Thank you very much, Adam. If you want to go this way, the dancer pictures are good. Miss Daphne. Kaylin. Congratulations. Thank you. Caitlin. Skylar. Definitely not least, Taylor. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to present to you your 2023-2024 Bonnie Award Scholarship winners. Thank you, ladies.
Hi everyone, welcome to Student Choreography 2021! So we figure you're here to see the dancers, which really you should be because they are amazing. We have 9 student choreographers and I have one waiting right here next to me, so I'm gonna pass the mic to her and we're gonna get started.
For 13 years. I'm a 6-year company member and I recently graduated high school. My dance is called Move and this is my second student choreography. The song is originally called Freedom by John Batiste, but I decided to name my dance Move to represent the freedom I feel when I dance, or in this case, Move. You may notice that I have a fairly large cast when they come out. And I did this so that the audience has a better chance of feeling the energy us dancers get from dancing with our peers. As I wrap up my last year in company, I thought it was only right to choreograph a very upbeat and fun dance. This is so I can portray the happiness and gratitude I feel from having the opportunity to dance at SCCDA alongside my best friends. I'm truly so proud of my cast, and I thank them for their hard work and smiles that brought my vision to life. Thank you all for coming, and I hope you enjoy.
Song for a long time. Someone had did it before in recitals a long time ago, and I wanted to redo the song. My dance is basically not called. My dance is about living your dog days and reminiscing about the dog days. You can take this as good days or bad days. I take mine as both. Stuff has happened along the way from quarantine till now, and I really reflect on a lot of things, you know, health, family, losses. And I wanted to put this all together in a dance to basically show in the beginning how it was before being sad, finding out losses, diagnosis, into finally living and being happy with yourself and everyone around you. So, yeah, it's a talk. Hope you guys like it.
Thank you. Enjoying yourself? So far, so good, yeah? I am going to pass the microphone to our president of San Diego Civic Dance Association, Mary Finley. Thank you, Andrea. Good evening, I'm back. Tom Hickey and I are board members, executive board members on San Diego Civic Dance Association, and we are just two people out of an army of people that work for the association to make everything as wonderful as it is. And sadly, there are times when members on the board move on to other parts of their life. And we have that tonight with two retiring board members. So we would like to invite those two members up. John and Megan, please join us up on stage. Thank you. Tom's going to say a few words.
Wow, John, you're finally a retired board member. No. If you don't know John, John is by far one of the most gentle souls I think I've ever met in this program. John is a great guy. He's a wonderful dad to Taylor. He's a great husband to Anna. He does a lot for this program that goes unseen. John is here at Strike. He's here at Setup when we're bringing things into the theater, out of the theater. He's helped with scholarships. He's done interviews. He's provided all sorts of things to the program that are just too numerous to document. He's been our saving grace with a big truck for things like shoe fairs. And we're going to miss John a lot. John, it's been a pleasure to get to know you over the last few years. I appreciate all you've done. The door is always open for you. And we'd like to thank you for being part of the board and part of the program. And you will definitely be missed.
Take off some limelight, John. Stay up here. Megan Casey Jones, come on down! Megan, come closer. I mean, you can hug Tom, but then come closer. All right. It's with great joy and a little bit of sadness, but I don't think Megan's going to go too far, that Megan, the best sidekick on live stream ever, she really stepped in and stepped up when we inherited this new amazing service to our community. And Megan, I know, is just very lighthearted. She's always willing to help out. She's always willing to set up a fundraiser. Go Rubios. She is just a wonderful mom. She's always present physically, emotionally. She's very easy to reach on text as well. Megan, it will be different without you. It will be sad without you, but I know you'll be watching. Even if you're not here in the theater, she'll be liking and subscribing on our YouTube channel. She does like those subscriptions, so if you haven't subscribed yet, do it for Megan. And thank you very much. Good luck in your next journey. So these are our two retiring board members. They have senior dancers. We have then one more round of applause, yes. We have two other board members of senior dancers who will be staying on the board with us, and we want to just acknowledge them for a moment.
So can we have Jasmine and Kristen come to the stage? Staying around and staying involved, and we'll be seeing them at future events and future meetings and relying upon their knowledge. We'd like to thank all of our board members who are in the audience for everything you do. And we appreciate everyone who contributes to the program.
And on that note, if you want to join the board, have we got a meeting for you. The best potluck this side of the Mississippi, end of June. Look for flyers coming to a lobby near you. And thank you very much. We're going to go back to the dancing, which is why you're really here. Although I could probably out-talk Alan, so. Thank you very much. I think it is, but for another night. So, thank you very much. Thank you very much to all of our volunteers, not only board members, but all of the volunteers sitting in the audience. And I saw you all come back on your day off to be here to support these dancers. Are you ready?
All right, I'm gonna bring out the third student choreographer.
This is my third and final student choreography with SDCBA. Yay! So this piece that I'm presenting today is titled Vienna Waits, and the song is Vienna by Billy Joel. So for a little bit of context for like my student choreography, I initially started choreographing for this piece in January. So I was on the way to Las Vegas to audition for a school for dance, and it was the night before, and I was just desperately looking for music, and then I suddenly picked the song, and I was like, oh, this is perfect. And I felt like I related to it a lot at the time because I was kind of going like through the motions of dance. I was like kind of burnt out in company. And then on top of that, I had college auditions, and that's a lot of work to do. So I picked this song at the time because it kind of helped me like to remind myself to slow down and take things as they are in the moment and not to like get too far ahead of myself. And I really liked that audition piece that I did, and the professors there really liked it too. So I was like, oh, let's see what else I can do with it. So then I decided to do this for my student choreography, and the process was really good, and I feel like working on it with my cast for the past few months kind of helped me to build up my confidence and build back my spark for dance again. So I hold a lot of appreciation for this dance, and I feel like it kind of grew with me from like the start of the year to this year. So yeah, I just want this dance to be a reminder to anybody that if you're feeling anxious about like the future, especially, you know, like seniors graduating, blah 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 blah, that like it's important to take things slowly and just to enjoy things as they are in the moment. So that can apply to anybody. This dance is open to any interpretation that you want. I'm really proud of my cast. I'm really thankful for this opportunity, and I hope you enjoy it.
You know you can't always see. So no matter what, I always got that little hip hop in there with my tap and jazz. So it's always been something I just love so much. My dance really is about just like letting go and having fun. Throughout my time in company, I was so worried about getting everything right that I forgot like why I was there in the first place, which was to enjoy myself and enjoy dancing. And I feel like I didn't really get to do that until my senior year. So this is really just like a message to myself and just to everyone, like, it's okay to have fun. Like, it's okay to let loose and just enjoy yourself. So thank you to my amazing cast. Oh my goodness. They have stuck with me through my crazy ideas and endeavors, and I really appreciate it. The song is a little fast, so thank you all for doing the fast choreo. Literally, like, y'all picked it up so quick too. I'm so impressed with you guys, and I'm really gonna miss you all. And thank you all so much. I hope you guys have fun watching.
Thank you. Thank you.
amazing, right? So you guys get me because the dancers are all changing costumes. So I'm gonna talk until they're all changed and then they're gonna come back and dance. We have, and they're super fast. Those of you that have never seen them before when they do collage in February and you're enjoying this, you really need to come. It's amazing. And some of these dancers do 30-second costume changes backstage. We're not going to do that today because we're not set up for that. I'm going to tell you a little bit about student choreo, but once they're ready to go, Rachel, you can let me know. By the way, you guys are an incredible audience. They are super excited to be doing this for you. Student choreo is one of those times of the year that they all look forward to. So for most of the year, they have staff and guest artists that come to work with them and set choreography on them. This is the one time of year in the spring that we open up the process to the students to audition pieces, and there are concepts for student choreography. So we have 9 this year, so you have 4 more, and they're coming up right now. So.
Hey guys, ignore the costume, it's for later. So I'm Daphne Jones, I'm a second year senior, and this is my first and last student choreo dance. Because it's my first and last, I decided to go a little sad. So my song is Before You Go by Lewis Capaldi. The original meaning behind the dance is pretty sad. It's talking about regrets of someone passing and not realizing the struggles that they went through until after they're gone. And so, we're not quite that dark, but this is talking about mental health and talking about something that I think doesn't get talked about a lot. About community and love for each other and opening up to people. Company definitely allowed me to open myself up more emotionally to people around me, and by me opening up to them, that allowed them to also find comfort in me and allowed them to open up to me too, which just overall helps everyone. So this dance is really about finding comfort in the people around you and finding a second family and everything, which is what Company and SDCDA has been for me. So I want to thank all my friends who came to the show. I want to thank my family who is here and my second family who is also here. Thank you for my teachers who pushed me to come out of my comfort zone through dance, which also allowed me to come out of my comfort zone emotionally too. Thank you to my friends at dance for being so amazing and being the people that I was able to open up to. Thank you to my dancers who brought this dance to life. They do an amazing job. And I just want to really quickly, like, I give a solo to each of my dancers because I wanted that to be a moment for them to open up to you all about their own struggles and everything. So I hope that you allow them to open up and see them for who they are. So thank you.
Oh, never the right time. Whenever you call, nobody to lose nothing at all. Or every moment, I start to play. But all I can think about is seeing that look on your face. When you hurt under the surface, like trouble but this world. So before you go, was there something I could have said to make your heart beat better? If only I'd have known you were so true. So before you go, was
because they just gave me so much experience in choreographing and just teaching in general. So thank you to all of you guys. And then I would like to thank my dancers, Kaylin, Skylar, Seat Lolly, Ayana, and Hazel. They're all such talented dancers, and I'm so happy I got all of them in my student choreo this year for my first student choreo. My dance is Let's Get Loud by J-Lo. So I hope there's a lot of noise for these girls, because they're crazy.
Woo! I'm Malia, and this is my third year in company. This is my first year doing a student choreo. So, basically, growing up, I've always been connected to Latino culture through its vast genres of music, including bachata, merengue, and salsa. This dance ended up being heavily inspired by salsa and ballroom techniques. So, the song is Mujer Latina by Thalia, and the whole dance embodies a perspective of being confident in one's identity and oneself. So, I really, really want to thank all of my dancers, Taylor, Alex, Bennett, and Kira. They did so amazing, and they always work so diligently in all of their rehearsals. Thank you so much to them, and thank you so much for everybody coming here tonight to support, and I really hope you enjoy it.
Woo! I've got to say that I'm so proud of all these choreographers. I just would like to give it up for all of them. They've all put in so much work. And I'm just super proud of everybody. My name is Daylin. I'm a 6 year in company. My dance this year is by Beyonce. It's a heels number. I wanted to do something for my last one that is a little special. I wanted to go out with a bang. My cast has, oh my gosh, like these girls have just been amazing. Every Tuesday they come ready to work. They never fail to make me laugh, make me smile. They have just been the best, and I'm gonna miss them so much when I leave. I love you guys so much. You ladies, go out and kill it. Thank you.
So, you know when you go to In-N-Out and there's the menu and the items on the menu seem really great, but then when you talk to people who work there or you get in the know, there's all these secret off the menu items. We have some off the program items for you tonight. So if you budgeted your time for an hour, and we are right on an hour, and you really have to be somewhere, we will not be offended if you have to go. But if you have about another half hour, we have some more dances that these dancers wanted to bring back to the stage. These are from class dances from War Memorial, recital dances that they wanted to have one more time on the stage to perform before these dances are retired and before our seniors are retiring. Woo! Until the next time they come back, hopefully, and dance on this stage, they are always welcome back home. So I am out here talking. I'll give you an idea of what's coming up, but they are furiously getting changed, and I think there are puddles and puddles of sweat backstage. So the outfit they're about to put on, I think, is gonna take some time because it is very, very nice. And not easy to put on when you're a puddle of sweat. So we are going to do Into the, which is Rachel's modern piece. We are bringing back It's Raining Men, which is Miss Connie's song. We are doing Tattoo, One Way or Another, and On the Floor, the Three Memorial Jazz. And then we are bringing back Rachel's fantastic musical theater, The Sparkling Diamond. So those are our In-N-Out off-menu items that, lucky for you, you get tonight and you don't even have to ask. We're just going to provide them for you. I want to take this moment. Are we still? No one is back there. That's a bad sign. They are all trying to get those unitards on. So I want to thank the people. First of all, I want to thank the choreographers that really took a leap of faith. Honestly, I've been choreographing for a very long time, and every time I decide to do a project, I feel like it's a little bit of a leap of faith that I'm gonna know what to do, because I have no idea. And every step of the way is kind of like, it's gonna happen. It's gonna come to me, step by step. So I know what these choreographers are going through. They say, yes, I'm gonna do a piece, I like this music, but then they have to come up with steps. They only have 6 weeks with about 50 minutes, each of those 6 weeks, so about 6 hours to put these dances together. Some of them have never been in sort of a mentor leadership capacity with their peers and their teenagers. You remember some of you a long time ago, some of you are still there. So there's, in addition to figuring out choreography, they're also navigating all of that. Then they work with Viviana, who's our amazing customer. Figure out what they're gonna wear. Our fantastic lighting designer, Bonnie Breckenridge, who we have not allowed to retire yet, does the light clock, and it's Miss Rachel, Miss Tiffany, who are backstage, Miss Jelly, that design the looks of the lights of what you see on the stage. Lana's on sound. We got Melissa and Megan on live stream, and Mary's also there. So I want to thank all those people, because this wouldn't happen with all of the support team that goes into making it. And is everybody ready? Rachel, do you have dancers? So I was not born in Bedford, Indiana. I was born in Boston, Massachusetts. I'm an East Coast girl. Yes, welcome back, Kenny. Let's see. and tell you the story about the squirrel that we had. Squirrel. So we had a squirrel a couple nights ago during dress rehearsal on the pipe overhead of the dancers. And when we did Michael Jackson's Bad, the squirrel seemed upset or agitated because it was this way and it flipped that way. So we're good, but suffice it to say, Alan went up in the lift and got the squirrel down, and Debbie and Rachel and I, curling, you know, the curling, the sport, we curled that squirrel out of the theater. So without further ado, here's our in and out portion.
Woo!
Okay, this time I'm not going to tell any more stories. So we're going to break up the lights so you guys can talk amongst yourselves. They're going to change here, and then we're going to have a bunch of dances in a row, I think. I have the paper, but I stopped looking at it a while ago. I don't really know at this point. It's like, whatever happens, this is the after hours part of the show. So we're going to break up the lights so you guys can just talk.
Thank you. Yeah.
Costume changing, we are going to bring the lights up. You can talk amongst yourselves and then we'll be all done. We really appreciate your enthusiasm hanging with us and supporting these dancers and our dance community. You guys have been awesome.
Thank you. indomitable, the one and only, Satine.
Thank you all for coming. And- We are done! Yay!